Hey everybody, Nick Yore here, bringing you a very special guest this week on the Prep Zone. We have Bishop Ireton girls head lacrosse coach Rick Sofield joining us. Thank you, coach, for joining us today. And how are you doing today?
I'm doing great today. It's good to be here.
Yep, great to have you in here. Off a great season this year, won the WCAC and the VISA state tournament, just a great year. So coming off that thrilling VISA 4 overtime win, by the way, just an absolute classic. Just talk about that moment in that tournament, what it meant for you and your team after that game.
The team worked really hard all year to get to that game, to have an opportunity to play St. Stephen's in the state championship. We've met each other the last 5 seasons in that game. So it's really a big part of what our season is built around, is being our best and being able to perform on that day in that game. So to have the girls, their hard work pay off and have the success that they worked all year for, it was just exciting. It was thrilling. I was so happy for them.
Yeah, and bit of a tough game there for you guys. It was very close. We had the lead early in the first half, and they came back to kind of tie it towards the end and go into overtime. Just how tough was that game, and especially during those 4 overtimes, to really pull that one out?
So, I mean, what it showed is it showed how gritty this group of girls really is. We're capable of being a very pretty team and make pretty plays, and we did that in the first half. We were up 5-1, and we were the pretty Bishop Ireton team. In the second half, we made mistakes. And St. Stephen's is a good team, and they capitalized on our mistakes. And we found ourselves in overtime, and we found ourselves in some bad situations in overtime with some tough turnovers or not coming up with a draw control. And so we were on defense a lot early in that overtime. And when we're in tough situations like that, you know, all the pretty goes out the window, and it's time for the gritty to kick in. And the girls are really gritty, and they delivered in crunch time.
Yeah, so speaking of St. Stephen's, St. Agnes, like you said, you faced them the past 5 years, and you beat them in overtime as well in this tournament last year in the final. And just talk about what that rivalry has been like, especially with you guys being so closely located.
Yeah, it's a great rivalry, and it's a friendly rivalry. A lot of these girls, they play together on club teams. They've played together in on their youth teams. I've coached some of them in club and youth lacrosse. And Coach Jenkins has coached some of our girls in club lacrosse. And so the kids know each other well. They hang out on the weekends, right? And they, and so they see each other a lot. And so to have the opportunity to really play a quality opponent that's so close, and the kids know each other well, the coaches know each other well, makes it really exciting. And this year we got to do it in Alexandria. So the crowd was amazing. There had to be 1,000 people there. To see the game. So I think it was great for the sport in the area, and I think it was a fantastic game.
Yeah, I noticed that you guys had the finals at Episcopal, and the boys were in Richmond, which didn't make a lot of sense to me since it was Paul VI and St. Stephen. So I was really liked how you guys did that. And you guys obviously have a loaded team this year. You had 13 Division I commits, but it was a true freshman in goal this year, especially in that championship game who came up big for you guys, Ashley Bowen, who made 14 saves and 4 in the overtime. I mean, if you go to 4 overtimes in sudden death, I mean, the goalie has to be making a lot of great plays. So just talk about her and how she's so special, so young, and the development you see for her in the future.
Yeah, absolutely. So we had a very nice season last year at Bishop Ireton, winning both the WCAC and state tournament last year. And this year we had about 50% turnover in our roster. We graduated 12 seniors from last year's team. So this year we had about 50% who had been there before, and we had 50% who were new. And that includes freshman players, and that includes transfer players who came in. And this was their first year with our team in this environment. Ashley's one of those players. So as a freshman, she stepped in. She shared time throughout the year. We have another very good freshman goalie in the program as well. But once we got to the finals of the state tournament, we felt Ashley was playing at her best, and she was the right person to put in the cage for that moment in that situation. And Ashley delivered. I mean, some of the saves she made were really, truly phenomenal saves. Our defense is designed for her to make certain saves. We want people to take shots from certain places, and she's responsible for making those saves. And when she doesn't, we let her know that's her job to make those saves. In this game, she made the save she's supposed to save, but she also made a couple of unbelievable saves. One in particular in overtime, one of St. Stephen's best players got free on a cut. And Ashley made an off-hip save that was just absolutely unbelievable. I thought the game was over. And Ashley saved the day for us, gave us another opportunity.
Yeah, that's just the amazing thing about lacrosse, especially sudden death with goalies. That's just one play could change the whole game. So like you said, it was a big focal point of your guys' season is the VISA State Tournament. But coming off such a successful run, winning the WCAC, we were there in style at Overcook Council in Maryland. I mean, it was just a great game. So what do you really tell your team to really how to focus back up after such a big win? And how do you get them mentally ready to go on and win another great tournament like the VISA, which could be even a little bit tougher?
So both tournaments are great tournaments, and we're really fortunate to be able to play in two. Most of our WCAC opponents don't have an opportunity to play for a state private school title, let's say. And a lot of our VISA opponents don't have the same type of conference championship game that we get the opportunity to play in the WCAC. So we're really fortunate to be able to compete in both tournaments. For us, neither tournament is more important than the other. They're okay. Both incredibly important. Mm-hmm. And we talk about them throughout the course of the year. One of our team mottos is six games in May. That means we want to be our best. We want to focus on peaking in May. And that's when our three WCAC tournament games are, and that's when our three VISA tournaments are. So when we talk about six games in May, we're talking about being our best to win both tournaments. We want to compete for championships in both.
Yeah, it's just amazing that you're able to win a double like that. I mean, back-to-back years as well. I mean, they talk about that in soccer all the time, but very rare in lacrosse. So when you're able to win those two big tournaments, what does that do for your program just moving forward and recruiting locally? Just what does that really do for you guys?
I mean, the biggest thing I think it does is it validates our culture. Culture doesn't develop on accident. It's something that we work on throughout the course of the year. It's our culture. I used the word gritty before. We're a gritty team. We work hard. These girls are in the weight room all off season. We start up summer workouts in 2 weeks, 2 weeks from today, actually. We start our summer workouts, and then we go in the gym before school on Tuesdays and Thursdays, beginning in September, beginning the first week of school at 6 a.m. And the girls get up early. They come. They work hard, and they get themselves ready physically, emotionally, mentally to peak in May. And so that's where our culture is, and that's the culture that we've tried to build. And an important thing with culture is it doesn't graduate, right? Mm-hmm. I talked about how 12 seniors graduated last year. 10 of those girls played college lacrosse. And how do you fill that void? You fill that void by falling back on your culture and the culture that we've developed. That culture doesn't graduate. And we're going to have, next year we're graduating four players who are going on to play in college. Three are going to be playing in the ACC. So incredible talent is leaving the program, but we have our culture to mm-hmm. fall back on. And the younger players, they buy into the culture and they develop within the culture. And by the time they're juniors and seniors, they're fully committed to the culture of success that we're trying to build.
Yeah, so speaking of culture and what you guys really do there, I mean, besides the 13 Division I commits you had on this year's team and all the ones you've had in the past, going to schools like UNC and different ACCs, like what is that what makes your program and your team so special? Is it that culture besides just obviously the raw talent that you're able to get every year?
100%. It's okay. The culture. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. We have talented players, right? And, you're not going to be successful on the field without kids who are great athletes, can throw and catch, play good defense, all those things. But what I think takes our team to the next level is the culture. And the kids buy into the culture and it gets passed down from year to year so that where we are now is that's just the way it is. The girls, I don't think a whole lot about mm-hmm. it. We talk about culture, but I don't think they spend a whole lot of time thinking about culture. It's just the way that it is. It's the way that we do things at Bishop Ireton.
Yeah, that's so true. Just from my time going to a senior game at Ireton in that championship game, you could just tell your girls were just different in how they were prepared and how they acted before and after the game. So it's very true about your guys' culture. So we'll get you out of here on this one. We have three straight WCAC titles and won four of the last five VISA tournament title programs. So obviously the program's in great shape, but where do you see the future of this program moving forward? Obviously a lot more titles and what you got coming up soon, like you said, summer workouts. So just what do you guys have moving forward?
So first of all, we elect our captains at the end of the season to carry us through the summer and into the next season.
That's great. Yeah.
And so we voted on three captains who are going to be outstanding. One of them, Brianna Lanta, is going to get interviewed on this show next. Mm-hmm. She's just a fantastic leader. She's a new transfer. This is her first year in our program, but she's immediately bought into the culture. And is prepared to be the leader, one of the leaders that we need to bring this next group of players up to the forefront, right? As one group, one class graduates, other kids have to step in and fill up. So really fortunate to have Brianna join our program you know, come into our family and embrace what it is to be a Bishop Ireton Cardinal and to be one of our leaders next year. Another player, Anna Kate Gately, was also elected captain. She's another kid who transferred into our program and has bought into our culture and is just a great ambassador for who we are and what we want to be. And our third captain is Maggie McHugh. And Maggie McHugh is a player who has been at Ireton for her first 3 years. And she's just, she's the kid who does everything right. That was one of our models this year, was do it right. In the classroom, in the hallways, in the community. And Maggie's just, she's the kid you want your daughters to grow up to be. She does everything right. She works hard. She's a good person. She's a fantastic student. And she represents what it is to be a Bishop Ireton lacrosse player to the younger girls. So with these three rising seniors coming in as captains, leading our summer workout sessions, helping to instill the values of, you know, playing hard, playing smart, playing fast, playing together, you know, playing like Bishop Ireton Cardinals, I think the future is very bright at Bishop Ireton.
Yeah, I would agree with that as well. I mean, sign of a great program if all these kids are really trying to come in and get a lot of transfers and get into your program. So it's just a great time for women's lacrosse here at Bishop Ireton. Thank you, Coach Sofield. And we will come right back with Bishop Ireton star Brianna Lanta, as who scored the game-winning goal versus St. Stephen's St. Agnes in the VISTA Championship. So don't go anywhere.